Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the virtual Harry Edwards Healing Sanctuary. So that music I just played was Temple of Silence by Duitu. I hope you enjoyed it. I always get totally lost in it. So you're very welcome to the healing minutes of the virtual Harry Edwards Healing Sanctuary. My name is Tara, if you don't know me already, and I today am coming to you from my home in Ireland. And this is a photo of me at the top of my very special mountain. So I thought I would share it with you. So now, as we prepare for the healing minutes, I'd like you to settle yourselves back into a space of calm and stillness, closing your eyes if it is safe for you to do so, and bring your awareness to the sensations of your breath, breathing in cool air in through your nose, and warm air out from your mouth. And just allowing this gentle rhythm and now expanding your awareness to the sensations that you are feeling in your body. Feel your feet rooted into Mother Earth. And I'd like you to just begin to imagine a beautiful big mountain path. Arms outstretched, and the wind blowing through your hair, a warm glow of sun on your face, and life feels good as you breathe in this beautiful, crisp morning air. Your smile is big and your eyes are bright. Adventure awaits you as you stroll on top to the top of the mountain. And on reaching the top, where you feel you can nearly touch the sky, you look out to this wonderful world, breathing in and breathing out as you feel the strength and the power of the mountain. To allow the flow of love and healing to come through us. As your crown chakra opens, you feel or imagine a column of pure white light filling your body. And then feel the balance and the harmony within your body as the earth energy rises up through the soles of your feet and your base chakra. You feel your connection to the universal source of pure, unconditional love, balanced by nurturing, protective love of Mother Earth. Harry Edwards prayer. May I be thankful for all the blessings I already have. Grant me relief from pain and sickness. Protect me from all ills, and grant me good health in the days to come. Remove all causes of imperfection and bring your healing ministers close to me, that I may be conscious of their presence and so receive guidance and inspiration. Grant me courage and fortitude to overcome all adversity. Let me be conscious of your strength in all times of need. Grant me the confidence to overcome my fears and not to anticipate harm. Teach me how to live rightly in your sight, to do only that which is right and true. I pray that good guidance and right influencing will inspire all your peoples to be as brothers one to the other, and that peace shall endure for all time. Amen. The Sanctuary Prayer. Heavenly Father, I surrender myself to the good influencing of your healing ministers in spirit, and that through your divine healing power, the disharmonies within me might be overcome, and the stresses of mind and body be eased and lessened day by day. Help me to adopt a more positive and helpful way of thought, bringing me into closer harmony with those around me and with the divine healing purpose, and for those who are sick or in the darkness of despair, who do not know of the help that can reach them from spirit. I pray that awareness will come to them soon, that they too might experience the upliftment of spirit that can lead us through harmony towards true health. May God bless you. Amen. We ask now that all the peoples whose names we hold in the distance healing folder may receive healing for their highest good. We also request healing for their family, friends, and people for whom they have requested distant healing. So we shall have our minute silence, a time for us all to reflect and send our distant healing thoughts out to the world and to our own family, friends, and animals, not forgetting to send healing to yourself. We call in Harry Edwards and our spirit team and our own personal guardian angels. May they all be placed in the healing light and receive which they are allowed to receive for their highest good. Our thanks and blessings for your help here today in sending out these wonderful energies, these healing energies. And thank you to our friends in spirit too. An angel blessing. May you be showered with angel blessings today. May the angels bring you peace and happiness, hope and divine comfort. May you be healed of whatever causes you pain. And may your whole life be filled with divine love and angelic light. So please do contact us in the normal way. You were only a phone call away. You can come to the sanctuary or telephone us or email us, and we can do distant healing on Zoom and on Skype. All our details are on our website and on Facebook. So please do come and see us. So the notices for today: the Bluebells Cancer Support Meeting will be held on Thursday the 7th and the 21st of July, and that's always from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. The Summer Fair is next Saturday, which I can't wait for. Lots of shopping, lots of fun, lots of socialising, so hopefully you can join us. And that's from 10 o'clock in the morning right through to 4 o'clock in the afternoon. On the 10th of July at 7:30, Alan will be doing his lovely healing for you. That was Alexa making a funny noise. Grief and Kapha meet on Thursday the 14th at the sanctuary at 10:30. And
I'm
also on
the
14th.
Check out the health section in your Ultimate Ideas app.
Okay, very sorry. Something's happening with the speaker, so we will. So on the 14th, Renu will be doing another one of her sound baths, and that will be at the sanctuary at 11 o'clock on the 14th. So details of these events for July are all on our Facebook page and website. Tracy will be back with us tomorrow, so please do join her. So, because I am at home in Ireland doing this virtual Harry Edwards Healing Sanctuary, everything is not in its normal place, so I may not even have music on the way out, but we'll see, because the machine has just done something funny. And there's birds and there's mice and there's everything, even cows in the fields outside, so you might hear it all. But as I said, coming home to Ireland this weekend, it had me thinking a lot about life and the choices we make. If I hadn't come over to England 26 years ago, you know, to work for the Prince's Trust charity, I wouldn't have met my husband. I wouldn't have married my husband. I wouldn't have had my three beautiful boys. And remembering back to my childhood, when I used to, coming home here made me think, I used to run around the mountains and I was always so happy and free and there were never any worries, and what would have happened if I'd stayed here? So anyway, as I entered my bedroom, my old bedroom, there beside my bed was a beautiful book called The Magic by Rhona Byrne. And I'd like to just read you a few pages from this book because I thought it was pretty special. Do you believe in magic? Remember when you were a child and you looked at life in total wonder and awe. Life was magical and exciting, and the smallest things were utterly thrilling to you. You were fascinated by the frost on the grass, a butterfly flittering through the air, or a strange leaf or rock on the ground. You were full of excitement when you lost a tooth, because it meant the tooth fairy would be coming that night. And you would count down the days to Christmas.
I'm having trouble
even though,
the internet.
Oopsie,
check out the health section oops, in your Ultimate Ideas app.
Just turn this machine off. So even though you had no idea how Santa Claus would get to every child in the world in one night, somehow he did, and he never let you down. Reindeer could fly. There were fairies in the garden. Pets were like people. Toys had personalities. Dreams came true. And you could touch the stars. Your heart was full of joy. Your imagination knew no limits. And you believed that life was magical. That every day promised more excitement and adventure. And that nothing could ever dull our joy for the magic of it all. But somehow we grew into adults. Responsibilities, problems, and difficulties took their toll on us, and we became disillusioned. And the magic we once believed in faded and disappeared. It's one of the reasons why adults love to hang out with children. I'm here to tell you that the magic you once believed in is still true. In fact, it can be more wondrous than you ever thought, more breathtaking and awe-inspiring than anything you've seen before, that all your dreams can actually come true. Something happened that changed my life for from that day on, I discovered a secret about life, gratitude. I practiced gratitude every day, and my life magically changed. The magic formula is to say the magic words, thank you. Gratitude is a feeling. So as you say the words thank you, really feel it in your heart. Feel it in your body. And by feeling it, this is what accelerates the magic in your life. So first thing in the morning, write your list. Type it into your computer or put it into a special journal that you keep all your gratitude in one place. Do it before bedtime too, so that your dreams are full of positive thoughts. This beautiful book is full of wonderful exercises to help you practice in different areas of your life, with relationships, health, and money. So with that, I say a very big thank you and a really heartfelt thank you for all of you joining us for this beautiful Healing Minutes at the virtual Harry Edwards. And as I said before, it would be absolutely lovely to see you at the sanctuary if you can make it. And I'm sure our lovely Harry Edwards is smiling down at us and is very grateful to us all too. So as I'm in Ireland, I thought I would send you an Irish blessing too. May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. The rains fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. I love that Irish blessing. So thank you again for joining us. I'm going to try the music again and we'll see, because I have a lovely upbeat song to go out on. But very exciting news that we have is that Doreen is back next Sunday. So I'm very excited to see her. So she's recovered really, really well. So I wish you a very, very lovely Sunday and a lovely rest of the week. And Tracy will be there tomorrow. And as I just find my lovely song that I want to send you guys out on, is, if we can make it work, here we go. Lovely Day by Bill Withers. So I absolutely wish you all a lovely, lovely day. And thank you for joining us. I'm wishing you so many blessings.
And I know it's gonna be a lovely day. When the day that lies ahead of me,
Wishing you all a lovely, lovely day. God bless you all. See you next time. Bye-bye.